Hello students, welcome to the lecture series of Engineering Physics in Gujarat Technological University GTU. We are discussing module number 3, ultrasonic and non-destructive testing. Today I am going to take a lecture on magnetostriction generator, which is second lecture out of the 7 lecture series. Let us start with the principle which is used in this generator, which is known as the magnetostriction effect. So let us write down principle of this generator. And that principle is nothing but magnetostriction effect. So let me write first what is magnetostriction effect. If possible, you may write with me also, and then we will discuss about this magnetostriction effect. So write down: when a ferromagnetic rod is subjected to an alternating magnetic field parallel to the length of road, the road undergoes the road undergoes alternate contraction and expansion equal to the frequency of applied magnetic field. This phenomena is known as magnetostriction effect. So this is about magnetostriction effect. હું તમને આખી ડેફિનેશન લાઈન ટુ લાઈન વાંચતો જાઉં અને સમજાવતો જાઉં છું, બટ જસ્ટ યુ હેવ ટુ રાઇટ ધીસ 4 લાઇન્સ about the magnetostriction effect. Now let us understand the entire things one by one. When a ferromagnetic rod is subjected to an alternating magnetic field. હવે જુઓ, તમે alternating electric field કે alternating voltage ભણી ગયા છો, AC voltage જેને આપણે કહીએ છીએ. The voltage which changes alternatively, it is known as the alternating voltage. Now see, somehow suppose we produce the magnetic field in which the north and south pole changes continuously. For some time the given end is north pole, then after some time it will changes to south, then again north, again south, north south, north south. Alternatively, if they changes, then such magnetic field is known as alternating magnetic field. And we have to keep the ferromagnetic road in this type of alternating magnetic field. Now we have to put the road in such a way that the length of the road is parallel to the magnetic field. Now let me draw this type of magnetic field. Suppose this is a ferromagnetic road. Suppose this is a ferromagnetic road. This is a ferromagnetic road. Ferromagnetic road. એટલે ધારો કે આ લોખંડનો સળિયો છે. We can take iron or cobalt or nickel or any other material. And here there is a magnetic pole. So suppose this is north at a given instant and this is south at given instant. So the magnetic field is from north to south. So the magnetic field is like this. Okay, north to south, this is magnetic field B. But this magnetic field B is alternating magnetic field. Alternating magnetic field. It means that when we look at this figure right now, this end is north and this end is south. Now after some time, north becomes south and south becomes north. So this direction changes. Again, this becomes north, this becomes south, this becomes south, this becomes north. So north, south, north, south, north, south changes, continuously changes. So the magnetic field here is not constant, but it changes alternatingly. So such type of magnetic field is known as alternating magnetic field. And we keep a ferromagnetic road of, let us say, length L in this type of magnetic field, where the length of road is parallel to the direction of magnetic field. Now when we place the ferromagnetic road in alternating magnetic field in such a way that the length of ferromagnetic road is parallel to the length, what happens to the road? Let us see that the road undergoes alternate contraction and expansion. Now contraction, eno Gujarati ma matlab thai sankochan, ane expansion eno matlab thai vistaran. Vistarvu etle expand thavu. So what happened to the road is, when this pole, suppose north, at that time suppose the length of road increases, so it expands, and here also. So when this becomes south, then this contracts. Again when it's south, it expands in this direction, again contracts. So this is supposed change in length. So the road is experiences vibration inside the field. So the road undergoes alternate contraction and expansion, or we can say that આવું જે છે એની બદલે તમારે બીજું લખવું હોય તો એમ લખી શકાય, or the road vibrates. એટલે રોડ જે છે એ વાઇબ્રેટ થાય, કંપન અનુભવે ટૂંકમાં. And the frequency of vibration is equal to the frequency of applied magnetic field. એટલે મેગ્નેટિક ફિલ્ડની જે બદલાવાની ફ્રિકવન્સી છે એટલી જ ફ્રિકવન્સીથી આ રોડ જે છે એ વાઇબ્રેટ થશે. Now this phenomena is known as the magnetostriction effect. The phenomena is known as the magnetostriction effect. So let me read it again. હવે સમજતા જજો. When a ferromagnetic road is subjected to an alternating magnetic field which is parallel to the length of road, the road undergoes alternate contraction and expansion, or we can say that the road vibrates at a frequency equal to the frequency of applied magnetic field. This phenomena of vibration of road when it is placed in alternating magnetic field is known as magnetostriction effect. જ્યારે ફેરોમેગ્નેટિક ધાતુના સળિયાને બદલાતા જતા ચુંબકીય ક્ષેત્રમાં મૂકીએ ત્યારે એ સળિયો જે છે એ વાઇબ્રેટ થાય છે, કંપન અનુભવે છે, અને એ કંપનની આવૃત્તિ એ જે ઓલ્ટરનેટિંગ મેગ્નેટિક ફિલ્ડ આપણે લગાડ્યું છે એની આવૃત્તિ જેટલી હોય એ અસર કે એ ઘટનાને આપણે કહીએ છીએ મેગ્નેટોસ્ટ્રિક્શન ઇફેક્ટ. સો ધીસ ઇઝ ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ. સપોઝ તમને એવું પૂછે કે રાઇટ પ્રિન્સિપલ ઓફ મેગ્નેટોસ્ટ્રિક્શન જનરેટર, ઓર બે માર્કમાં એવું પૂછે ઘણીવાર કે રાઇટ વોટ ઇઝ મેગ્નેટોસ્ટ્રિક્શન ઇફેક્ટ, સો ધીસ ઇઝ ધી આન્સર. યુ હેવ ટુ ડ્રો અ ડાયાગ્રામ એન્ડ ટુ રાઇટ ધીસ મચ લાઇન્સ. નાઉ સી, this is second part is about the construction of magnetostriction generator. So second is the construction. So first is principle, which is the magnetostriction effect. Here it is explained. Now second part is construction of magnetostriction generator. So here is the final figure or generator or diagram of magnetostriction oscillator, but I am drawing the same diagram here and explain each one by one, each parts of this figure one by one. So suppose this is ferromagnetic road. So this is the ferromagnetic road. This is ferromagnetic road. Okay, this is ferromagnetic road. Now, two coils are wounded over this road. So suppose here is one coil. This is coil number L2. This is coil number 1, which is L1. એટલે બે ગૂંચળા જે છે એને આની સાથે બાંધી દીધા. સો ટુ કોઇલ્સ આર વાઉન્ડેડ ઓન ઓવર ધી ફેરોમેગ્નેટિક રોડ. વન ઇઝ L1, સેકન્ડ ઇઝ L2. ધ રોડ લેન્થ ઇઝ AB. This is A. This point is A and this point is B. Now, with L1 coil in parallel to it, we connect a capacitor which is variable one. So, a capacitor variable is connected with the L1 C1. So, this is, let us say, C1. Now, this circuit. હવે જો આને યાદ કરો, આવું તમે ક્યાંક ભણી ગયા છો. ધીસ ઇઝ ધીસ ફોર્મ L1 C1 ઓસિલેટરી ઓર ટેન્ક સર્કિટ. તમે 12મા ધોરણમાં ભણીને આવ્યા છો LC દોલનો, LC ઓસિલેશન્સ. So when L and C are connected parallel to each other, the charge is oscillating between the plates of capacitor. That phenomena is known as LC oscillation. જ્યારે ઇન્ડક્ટરની સાથે એક કેપેસિટરને સમાંતરમાં જોડવામાં આવે તો વિદ્યુત ભાર કેપેસિટરની બે પ્લેટ વચ્ચે દોલનો કરે છે, જેને આપણે LC દોલનો કહીએ છીએ, અને એ પરિપથને ટેન્ક પરિપથ કે LC દોલક પરિપથ એવું કહેવામાં આવે. સો ધીસ ઇઝ નથિંગ બટ LC ઓસિલેટરી સર્કિટ, ઓર વી કેન સે દેટ ઇટ ઇઝ અ ટેન્ક સર્કિટ ઇન વિચ એન ઇન્ડક્ટર એન્ડ કેપેસિટર્સ આર કનેક્ટેડ પેરેલલ ટુ ઈચ અધર. નાઉ ધીસ વન end of this LC circuit, one end of this LC circuit is connected with the connected with emitter, and the second part of emitter, this is milliammeter, to check current through the circuit, and the second part is connected with the transistor. So this is the transistor circuit. This is suppose a transistor, and this transistor, sorry, this is the transistor part. Now transistor has three terminals. This is typical sketch of transistor. Okay, so this part is known as base of transistor, this is known as collector of transistor, and this is known as emitter of transistor. So emitter, base and collector are two three fundamental concept fundamental connections of transistor. So we connect this milliammeter with the collector of transistor. So between collector and emitter of transistor, we connect LC circuit via milliampere meter. So this is NPN transistor, so we have to put arrow from base to emitter. So the second end of emitter is connected through this via a battery. So here is a battery. So this is also variable. This is battery. So see, let me tell you connection once again. The L1 C1 oscillatory circuit is the key component or key circuit to this generator. This L1 C1 oscillatory circuit is connected between collector and emitter via battery and milliammeter. So between collector and this, an emitter is connected. Between emitter and this combination, a battery is connected. Now see, the L2, this coil is connected between base and emitter of the transistor. So here is the base, and this end is connected with the emitter. So this is the entire circuit diagram of magnetostriction generator. Now these two coils L1 and L2, L1 and L2 are connected mutually, and it is known as very famous phenomena, which is mutual inductance. Mutual inductance. So L1 and L2 એ બંને અન્ય અન્ય પ્રેરકત્વથી જોડાયેલી છે. આ તમે ભણી ગયા છો. The current in one coil induces the EMF in second coil. The effect is known as mutual inductance, જેને આપણે અન્ય અન્ય પ્રેરણ કહીએ છીએ. So this L1 and L2 are near to each other, and they are connected via this magnetic rod. Magnetically they are connected, and we can write like this: L1 and L2 are connected mutually. Now let us see about the working of this circuit. Let us discuss about the working of the magnetostriction generator. See, that is explanation part. Apde ema bahu jaju lakshu nahi, pan hu tamne samjavi dau kevi rite kaam kare che. The more you can read in the book. So whenever we switch on the battery, the capacitor C1 starts charging. Suppose the charge on this plate is positive and the capacitor is charging right now. So this plate of capacitor becomes positively charged and this plate of capacitor becomes negatively charged. Now when this is fully charged, at that time this charge is passing through this inductor and come back to the opposite plate. So whenever charge passing through this coil L1, it induces the current. Charge je che ahi thi pasar thato, eno matlab ke charge gati ma ho, etle pravah pasar thyo. Now that current of coil L1 induces EMF in coil L2, and as we know that the mutual EMF which is induced in this is according to Lenz's law, this is opposite in direction to the current in this circuit. So the current which is induced in L2 is in opposite direction to that of current induces in L1. So suppose during this situation this end becomes south of the battery and this end become north of the coil. So one end is north, another one end is south. So magnetic field is generated via this two coils L1 and L2 in opposite direction. So તમે એવું સમજી શકો કે કોઈ એક કોઇલ છે એ એક ધ્રુવ તરીકે કામ કરે છે. વન ઇઝ બિહેવ એઝ અ સાઉથ પોલ અને નેક્સ્ટ વન ઇઝ ઓપોઝિટ વન ઇઝ બિહેવ એઝ અ નોર્થ પોલ. સો ધીસ વિલ હેપન અન્ટિલ ધીસ એન્ટાયર પોઝિટિવ ચાર્જ એક્યુમ્યુલેટ ફ્રોમ ધીસ પ્લેટ ટુ ધીસ પ્લેટ. આફ્ટર ઇટ સપોઝ ધીસ પ્લેટ ઇઝ પોઝિટિવલી ચાર્જ આફ્ટર સમ ટાઈમ, ધેન અગેન ધ ચાર્જ ઇઝ મૂવિંગ ઇન ઓપોઝિટ ડિરેક્શન એન્ડ કમ બેક ટુ ધીસ પ્લેટ. At that time current decreases, so this end we consider it as a north and this end we consider it as a south. So charge is oscillating across the plates of capacitor C1 during the charging and discharging of this capacitor. This magnetic field inside the ferromagnetic rod changes by south north south north south north. So we produce is the alternating magnetic field for the vibration of this ferromagnetic rod, and when the resonance occur at that time we get the ultrasonic waves which are parallel to the length of rod. We get the ultrasonic waves in this direction. So these are the direction here, it is shown here. So this indicates dotted line vibration of the rod, and this is the entire working of the magnetostriction. Now as we know that the frequency of tank circuit is 1 upon 2 pi under root LC, here is L1 C1, and the frequency of vibration of rod, frequency of vibration of rod, vibration of rod F is equal to 1 upon 2L under root Y by rho, where y is Young's modulus and rho is density of the material of rod, L is length of the rod. So when this frequency is equal to this frequency, when these two frequencies are equal, at that time resonance condition is achieved, and at the time of resonance the rod vibrates with the maximum amplitude. As we know that at resonance, at frequency matching situation, the two rods are vibrating with the identical frequency and amplitude of the rod becomes maximum. So we get at that time we get the ultrasonic waves parallel to the length of rod. Ave farithi let me explain you in Gujarati also. See this, the circuit L1 C1, jyare apde battery shuru kariye tyare aa capacitor ni plate je jamni baju ni che e positively charge thashe. જેવું આ સંપૂર્ણ ચાર્જ થઈ જાય એટલે કરંટ જે છે એ L1 માં થઈ અને C1 માં જશે, એટલે ચાર્જ જે છે એ C1 માં થઈ L1 માં થઈ અને સામેની પ્લેટ પર જમા થશે, ડાબી બાજુની પ્લેટ પર. એ વખતે L1 માંથી પ્રવાહ પસાર થશે. જેવો L1 માંથી પ્રવાહ પસાર થાય એટલે આની સાથે ફ્લક્સ સંકળાશે, એ ફ્લક્સ લિંક થવાના લીધે આમાં પણ EMF અને જેના કારણે આમાં પણ પ્રેરિત પ્રવાહ ઉત્પન્ન થશે. હવે આપણે ભણી ગયા છીએ એમ લેન્ઝ ના નિયમ પ્રમાણે આમાં જે પ્રવાહ પ્રેરિત થાય એની દિશા આના કરતા વિરુદ્ધ હશે. એટલે આ જો સાઉથ પોલ થતો હોય, ધારો કે આ દક્ષિણ ધ્રુવ થાય છે, तो आ उत्तर ध्रुव थशे सो इफ दिस इज साउथ देन दिस बिकम्स नॉर्थ જ્યારે આ આખું સાયકલ પૂરું થાય એટલે આ પ્લેટ સંપૂર્ણ પોઝિટિવ ચાર્જ થઈ જાય એટલે ઊંધી પ્રોસેસ થશે પાછા આ ચાર્જીસ છે ઇન્ડક્ટર L1 માં થઈ અને જમણી બાજુની પ્લેટને ચાર્જ થશે એટલે એને ડિસ્ચાર્જિંગ કહેવાય એટલે ચાર્જિંગ ડિસ્ચાર્જિંગ થાય ત્યારે ધારો કે ચાર્જિંગ દરમિયાન આ સાઉથ રહેતો હોય તો ડિસ્ચાર્જિંગમાં નોર્થ થાય પાછો સાઉથ પાછો નોર્થ પાછો સાઉથ પાછો નોર્થ એમ અહીંયા ફેરોમેગ્નેટિક રોડમાં ઓલ્ટરનેટિંગ મેગ્નેટિક ફિલ્ડ એ પ્રોડ્યુસ થઈ ગયું ઓલ્ટરનેટિંગ મેગ્નેટિક ફિલ્ડ પ્રોડ્યુસ થાય એટલે શું થાય રોડના વાઇબ્રેશન શરૂ થશે કેમ કે આપણે ઉપર મેગ્નેટોસ્ટ્રિક્શન ઇફેક્ટમાં એવું જોયું કે જ્યારે જ્યારે ફેરોમેગ્નેટિક રોડને ઓલ્ટરનેટિંગ મેગ્નેટિક ફિલ્ડમાં મૂકવામાં આવે ત્યારે એમાં વાઇબ્રેશન થાય છે સો નાવ સી ધ ફ્રીક્વન્સી ઓફ વાઇબ્રેટિંગ રોડ ઇઝ ગિવન બાય ધીસ ફોર્મ્યુલા 1/2L અંડર રૂટ વાય બાય રો ઇઝ ધ formula of frequency of vibration of road and this is very famous formula we have L1 inductor and LC1 capacitance so L1 1 upon 2 pi under root L1 C1 is the frequency formula for the LC oscillatory circuit so jyare anunad thai resonance thashe tyare aa banne frequency equal thai e vakate aa je road che ferromagnetic road e મેક્સિમમ એમ્પ્લિટ્યુડથી વાઇબ્રેટ કરે એટલે કે ત્યારે એનો કંપ વિસ્તાર જે છે એ મહત્તમ બને અને એ વખતે એને સમાંતર જે વેવ છે આ એ જનરેટ થશે જે અલ્ટ્રાસોનિક વેવ છે સો ધ ફ્રીક્વન્સી વી કેન રાઇટ લાઈક ધીસ ધ ફ્રીક્વન્સી ઓફ સોરી ધ ફ્રીક્વન્સી ઓફ vibrating road the frequency of vibrating road is f equal to 1 upon 2l under root y by rho where y is young's modulus rho is density of the material of road and L is length of road now this is the frequency of vibration and the frequency of tank circuit or LC circuit or LC oscillatory circuit f is equal to 1 upon 2 pi under root L1 C1. So the situation where these two frequencies become equal at that time we get the ultrasonic wave. So we can write like this at resonance 1 upon 2L under root Y by rho is equal to 1 upon 2 pi under root L1 C1. This is the condition of resonance when this happen at this situation road vibrates with maximum amplitude and ultrasonic wave is generated parallel to the length of road so this is the working of magnetostriction generator or magnetostriction oscillator so this is the working magnetostriction generator and the last two points which are important are merits એટલે advantages એટલે કે એના ફાયદા and demerits एंड डीमेरिट्स एटले डिसएडवांटेजेस ऑफ दिस जनरेटर. सो लेट अस डिस्कस मेरिट्स फर्स्ट. वॉट आर दी यूजेस और एप्लीकेशंस और एडवांटेजेस टू यूज दिस जनरेटर. फर्स्ट इज द डिजाइन ऑफ द ऑसिलेटर. जो क्यारेक ऑसिलेटर लखू क्यारेक जनरेटर लखू एक ना एक ज वर्ड छे. डिजाइन ऑफ द ऑसिलेटर इज वेरी सिंपल एंड कॉस्ट इज लो. सी दिस इज वन ऑफ द बेस्ट एडवांटेज ऑफ दिस जनरेटर. इफ यू लुक एट द सर्किट डायग्राम वी रिक्वायर अ फेरोमैग्नेटिक रोड विच इज इजीली अवेलेबल. दिस टू कॉइल्स आर इजीली अवेलेबल, कैपेसिटर्स आर अवेलेबल, ट्रांजिस्टर एंड बैटरी आर अवेलेबल. सो इट इज वेरी सिंपल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक पार्ट दे रिक्वायर्ड. And due to that, as the all parts are very simple and cost effective, so the overall cost of the generator is very low as compared to the other generators. Second is at low ultrasonic frequencies, large power output is possible. Now see, this is second advantage of this generator. So if our frequency generated by this generator is very low as compared to the piezoelectric generator, but though frequency is very low, we can get the large power output through this generator. એટલે ભલે આવૃત્તિ છે એ પ્રમાણમાં ઓછી મળે પણ તમારો પાવર આઉટપુટ વધારે છે એટલે તમને આનાથી કમ્યુનિકેશન કરવું હોય તો તમે એના આ સિગ્નલ્સ છે એનો યુઝ કરી શકશો. એન્ડ થર્ડ ઇઝ ધી ફ્રીક્વન્સી રેન્જિંગ ફ્રોમ 100 હર્ટ્સ ટુ 3 મેગાહર્ટ્સ. 3 મેગાહર્ટ્સ can be produced. We can produce the frequency up to 3 megahertz. 3 megahertz avrutti sudhi na tame waves je che ultrasonic waves e aa generator thi melvi shako. So this is one of the advantage or a merit of this generator. Now let us discuss about the demerits of this generator. First is, see, it is able to generate ultrasonic waves up to 3 megahertz, but it cannot generate the ultrasonic waves having frequency more than 3 megahertz. So first limitation is this: it cannot generate ultrasonic waves having frequency more than 3 megahertz. This is first limitation. So to generate a high frequency ultrasonic wave, suppose we want to generate 10 megahertz, 100 megahertz, 30 megahertz, like that, we have to use the piezoelectric generator. This is it is not possible with the help of magnetostriction. We'll see in the discussion of numerical that why it is not possible with the help of magnetostriction generator. The frequency of oscillator depends upon the temperature. See, this is one of the major limitation. Tame સમરમાં અને વિન્ટરમાં વાપરો તો જુદી જુદી ફ્રીક્વન્સી મળે. દેર શુડ બી માઇનોર ડિફરન્સ ઇન ધી ફ્રીક્વન્સી, બટ યુ કેન નોટ જનરેટ કોન્સ્ટન્ટ ફ્રીક્વન્સી થ્રુઆઉટ ધી યર. વેન ધ ટેમ્પરેચર ઇન્ક્રીઝિસ ધ ફ્રીક્વન્સી ઇન્ક્રીઝિસ, ટેમ્પરેચર ડિક્રીઝિસ ધ ફ્રીક્વન્સી ઓલ્સો ડિક્રીઝિસ. સો ધ ફ્રીક્વન્સી ડિપેન્ડ્સ અપોન ધી ટેમ્પરેચર. એન્ડ થર્ડ એડવાન્ટેજ is there will be some losses. There will be some energy losses of energy due to hysteresis and eddy current. હવે તમે આ બંને 12મા ધોરણમાં ભણી ગયા છો. ફેરોમેગ્નેટિક મટીરીયલ છે એટલે એમાં હિસ્ટેરેસિસ લૂપ નાની નાની મળશે અને હિસ્ટેરેસિસ લૂપનું એરિયા જે છે એ હીટમાં કન્વર્ટ થાય. એટલે તમે આખો પ્રેક્ટિકલ કરો અથવા તો આ જનરેટરને થોડો સમય સુધી વાપરો અને પછી જુઓ તો એ જનરેટર જે છે એ ગરમ થઈ ગયો છે. સો ધેટ હીટ ઇઝ પ્રોડ્યુસ્ડ ડ્યુ ટુ હિસ્ટેરેસિસ એન્ડ એડી કરન્ટ્સ. So these are the limitations and these are the advantages and these are the disadvantages of this generator. So this is all about magnetostriction generator, starting from principle, which principle is used in this generator. Then after we saw about the construction and working of the generator. Construction is very simple. There is a circuit diagram and you have to explain each part of this circuit, which is construction. Working merits and demerits. So working is very simple. The frequency of vibrating rod is given by this formula and the frequency of LC circuit is this. When we compare this to the resonance condition is achieved and we get the ultrasonic waves parallel to the length of rod. And these are merits and demerits of the generator. Now let us discuss this part also. This we saw previously. The production of ultrasonic waves by two types of generator, electrical and mechanical. Mechanical generators are not in our syllabus. In our syllabus only electrical generators are there, which are further divided into two parts. One uses the magnetic effect, which is magnetostriction, and one uses the electrical effect, which is piezoelectric. So there are two generators, magnetostriction generator and piezoelectric generator. Now today we discussed about the magnetostriction generator. So this is the title and this is very favorite topic for all GTU examiners. So it is very important for the GTU examination also. So first is the principle, which is the magnetostriction effect. Let us see this once again. When a ferromagnetic rod is subjected to alternating magnetic field parallel to the length of rod, the rod undergoes alternate contraction and expansion at a frequency equal to the frequency of applied magnetic field. This phenomena is known as magnetostriction effect. It is explained here. This north is not permanently north, this south is not permanently south. They are changing continuously. North becomes south and south becomes north. And the material which is used to produce ultrasonic waves are known as magnetostriction material, like iron, like cobalt, like nickel or alnico, all alloy are the magnetostriction materials which are ferromagnetic one. Then after there is a construction, the same diagram is shown here, the magnetostriction generator. The important parts are this L1 C1 circuit, transistor, and this L2 coil, which is connected mutually with the L1 and acts to produce the alternating magnetic field. So whatever is in the figure that you have to write is the construction. The construction is shown in the figure. Ferromagnetic rod AB, this one is clamped in the middle. એટલે અહીંથી એને clamp લગાડેલો જેથી કરીને એ પડી ન જાય. The coils L1 and L2 are wounded at the ends of the rod. એટલે અહીંયા બે કોઇલ આપણે wound કરી છે. To the coil L1 variable capacitor C1 is connected. Now see, C1 is connected with the coil L1 in parallel and this form the tank resonator or LC oscillatory circuit. One side of the tank circuit is connected to the collector through emitter and other side is connected through emitter through battery. So this end is connected to battery and to emitter and other side is connected with collector via battery. This C is here. This is the C. And coil L2 is connected between emitter and base, which is used to feedback loop. So this is connected between base and emitter and used as a feedback loop. Now working, when the battery is switched on, the resonator circuit is at a frequency which is equal to L1C1. Now rod is magnetized by the collector current, and any change in collector current causes the change in magnetization, and rod vibrates, which is the magnetostriction effect. Now this magnetization causes change in magnetic flux associated with coil L2 in the base circuit, and EMF is induced in the coil L2. This EMF is given to the base circuit and fed back to coil L1 to maintain this LC oscillation. And at the resonance, the rod vibrates with maximum amplitude and thereby producing the ultrasonic waves which are parallel to the length of rod, which are shown here. So these are the ultrasonic waves produced by the generator. Now this is the condition of ultrasonic resonance. The frequency is, this is general formula, E is elastic constant, but for solid E is Young's modulus Y, rho is density, L is length of the rod, and this is the resonance condition. When this condition achieved, we get the ultrasonic waves. And then after, these are few merits and demerits of the ultrasonic waves, which we discussed few minutes back. So frequency up to 3 megahertz can be produced, and it cannot produce frequency more than 3 megahertz. And to generate the frequency having more waves having more than 3 megahertz, we have to use piezoelectric generator. So this is second type of generator. Now see, the terminology or the language of this book is designed in such a way that only generator differs from the one point to another, but the working part remains the same. Here we use the ferromagnetic rod. In piezoelectric generator we use the quartz crystal. We will discuss that in next lecture, but the analogy between these two generator is very similar, and if we replace the magnetic one with the electric one, we get the new generator, which is the piezoelectric generator. So piezoelectric generator is electrical version of the magnetostriction generator. એટલે આપણે જે આવતા લેક્ચરમાં piezoelectric generator જોવાના છીએ એ શું છે, એ મેગ્નેટિક જનરેટર નું ઇલેક્ટ્રિક રૂપ છે. એટલે જે વર્કિંગ અહીંયા લખ્યું છે એ બધું સેમ છે, એમાં બહુ માઇનોર ચેન્જ થશે વર્કિંગમાં અને કન્સ્ટ્રક્શનમાં પણ. બટ જે બેઝિક સિદ્ધાંત છે કે ક્રિસ્ટલ વાઇબ્રેટ થાય, વાઇબ્રેશનની ફ્રીક્વન્સી એ એલસી સર્કિટના દોલનોની ફ્રીક્વન્સી જેટલી થાય, અને એ વખતે પેરેલલ લેન્થને પેરેલલ અલ્ટ્રાસોનિક વેવ ઉત્પન્ન થાય, એ બંનેમાં સેમ રહે. સો This is all about magnetostriction generator. I hope you will enjoy this video lecture, and in next lecture we will discuss about the next second type of generator, piezoelectric generator. Thank you very much.